Hello, everybody! This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome back to the Spyro the Dragon playthrough. In our last episode, we finished off Beast Makers with Wild Flight, the fourth flight level, and Metalhead, the fourth boss. We now have 8,000 gems, 58 dragons, for 72% completion, which means it is time to move on. The next world awaits, and you guys know the drill at this point. It's time to talk to the balloonist. I feel much better now that so many dragons have been rescued. Jump in the balloon and I'll show you the Dreamweaver's world. Well, there's no sense in standing around here wasting time. Let's go ahead and make the journey. From the Dismal Swamp, welcome to Dreamweaver's World 5, and quite a change in scenery from the Dismal Swamp of Beast Makers. Quite a change indeed. And this is definitely a dream world, and that is going to become very apparent throughout the different levels of this world. Here we have the portal to Dark Passage, the first level. That'll be the first level that we tackle in the next recording. In this episode, we are focusing on the home world. And right away, we come across some pretty interesting enemies. We've got enemies that can change size thanks to a cannon on that island in the middle of the map. We're gonna have to take control of that cannon in order to actually complete this world. But before we do that, let's take a detour over here to Dragon Number 1.
Welcome to the Dreamweavers, young one. While chasing Nasty's minions in this world, you must expect the unexpected and prepare for what is not there.
He's not kidding there. There are definitely going to be some challenges and obstacles that we're going to have to overcome that are very interesting. This world and the levels within it are going to throw quite a few different gimmicks at us and some very interesting enemies to deal with. Here we have the portal to Lofty Castle. That is our second level that we will be tackling. And moving on. So now let's go ahead and take control of that cannon out in the central island. And as you can see, to drive home the dream gimmick, we are very, 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 very high up in the sky. Which means we are in constant danger of deadly pitfalls. That is one constant threat in the Dreamweaver's levels, the threat of falling off the stage, even more so than in Magic Crafters. Although oddly, despite being the world that comes after Beastmakers, I personally find Dreamweaver's easier. I think Beastmakers is the true difficulty spike, as if you will. Now, that doesn't mean Dreamweavers is piss easy, but I don't find it quite as challenging as Beastmakers. Now, we need to commandeer the cannon because there are some enemies that... You saw that Mook controlling the cannon, and he was changing the size of some of these enemies. Well, there are some enemies that he doesn't shoot at, namely the three armored enemies that I just shrunk down. Now, if these armored enemies are large, you cannot kill them no matter what, so you have to shrink them down in order to kill them by charging. Unfortunately, Spyro himself cannot be hit with the laser, but it would be interesting to think about what he'd turn into. Probably a purple version of King Ghidorah, but we'll leave that to the imagination. In any case, here is Dragon Number 2.
Hello, Spyro. Nicely done.
I'll be done when I've toasted that nasty Nork.
Spyro says, keep your compliments to yourself. And he is right. We are not done yet. Not by a long shot. Although I'm sure Nasty Nork is getting quite nervous right now because we are actually very, very close to finally confronting him. It won't be long before Nasty Nork gets what's coming to him. But that's not for quite a while. It's getting close. But we cannot get ahead of ourselves. Anyway, there's the portal to Haunted Towers, one of the most challenging levels in the entire game. That will be our final main level of Dreamweavers. And now we have a very interesting enemy up ahead. This is the Fool. Now the thing about the Fools is that these guys pop up periodically all throughout Dreamweavers. And the thing is, the Fools are invincible. You cannot kill them. Instead, what will happen when you attack a Fool is a special effect will happen. In the Dreamweaver's home world, the Fools will turn into timers. Activate the timer and something will happen, like a platform will lower or a secret will be revealed, something like that. The thing about the Fools is that once you activate their timer, you have to react very quickly to get what you need, because that timer will run out, and once it runs out, you have to attack the Fool again to make him reactivate his timer. Anyway, here's our last dragon.
The Fools you see in this world are invincible, but that does not mean they shouldn't be attacked.
Sounds all right to me.
And that is 61 dragons! I forgot to make a note of it when we had 60 dragons. We are now less than 1/4 of the way from completing the game. I probably didn't phrase that correctly. We are more than 3/4 of the way done at this point. Approximately 74% overall. Not too far away from being a solid 75. So that should give you an idea of just how far we've come, but also how much farther we have to go. Anyway, we can finally take out those armored enemies, which we couldn't earlier, but we are now able to thanks to having taken control of the cannon. And now we have another Fool area. This is one where you have to work quickly. You have to flame both Fools to activate these platforms, and then quickly make your way across. And boom, nicely done. Although the Fools here in the home world aren't that much of a problem, but there is one level later on where they are going to be more of a factor, and the challenges are going to be a little more precarious. Anyway, here is the portal to Icy Flight. That is the final flight level of the game, and definitely one of the more challenging ones, to be certain. I'll take that extra life. We're done with the Fools, at least for the home world. So one last area, and we should have the home world fully explored, and that's always a nice thing. First, we have the final portal of this world. We have Jock. Jock is the boss of Dreamweavers. That will be the very last thing that we tackle before we're all ready to move on. And speaking of moving on, here's the balloonist for Dreamweavers. Nice job collecting so much stolen treasure. But beware, Spyro. Nasty's world is not the most friendly place you will find. Yes, we can actually go ahead and skip ahead straight to Nasty's world, so we can go right on his doorstep. However, we are obviously not going to do that right now. We still have the entire set of worlds for Dreamweavers to explore. I've been making this 100% so far, and I'm not stopping now. So yes, we can go straight to Nasty's world. I do not remember the exact requirement. I think you have to collect at least 6,000 gems to reach Nasty's world. It might be 6,500. I'll have to look it up and make a note in post-production. But in any event, we're going to wrap things up here. So we have explored Dreamweaver's homeworld, and we are going to stop here. So now we have 8,300 gems, 61 dragons for a solid 75% completion, which means we're going to wrap things up. So that is it for this episode of the Spyro the Dragon playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, be sure to like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode.